I'm Julie Cook. My dad, Turney Black, Anthony Black, but everybody called him Turney, and also my grandfather, Alfred Acaster, had worked on the barges a lot of years. My granddad had been on the barges with his dad since he was 13, 14. My dad went to work on the barges when my brother was born because he was at sea, and my granddad didn't like the thought of him going off to sea when my mum had a young baby. My first memories was going on as a child on the barge on regular occasions with a group of with all our families, nieces and nephews. My granddad used to take all his grandchildren down there. On one occasion, my youngest nephew would have only been about two or three, so that he didn't fall into the river. They tied a rope round his waist and then tied him to the funnel actually on the barge, so that he didn't fall over. We would go up and down the canal, have a picnic type lunch on there, and then back again. Really regarding the Humber Bridge, I remember my dad being really excited about being picked, one of his barges to be picked to take like the road platoons in. I can remember as a child when we knew it was going to be on the TV, we were all really excited. And as I say, my mum got us all to sit round and watch, and we were trying to work out which one was my dad, which was my granddad, and which was my uncle. And I think it was just because of the way it was filmed. I don't know whether we ever did. We'd be like, that's my dad, that's my... Oh no, that could be him, that could be him. So yeah, it was just really exciting. And I remember my dad even, make sure they've got the telly on, make sure you've got the TV on, ringing my mum up, obviously not mobile phones then. And we had a house phone. Oh, I'm gonna be on the TV, make sure the kids are watching. And then, you know, us just saying, oh, we couldn't see which one was you, Dad, when we looked at it on the telly and things like that. So, and then obviously we would speak to our cousins who'd done the same, trying to look for their dad. And we were all in the same house, but we all lived quite close together. So yeah, it was a big family memory that we've got, and we still chat about now. Unfortunately, I said my dad and my granddad are no longer here. It was just lovely to be part of it, and I still feel very proud now when I'm fortunate that I live near the bridge. But you know, I tell my kids about the granddad being part of it, and you know that I'm my grandkids now. I say, oh, your granddad that they unfortunately never met, he helped build that bridge. So yeah, it has become part of our family in a lot of ways, I think. Another nice memory that I've got is of my granddad, Alf Acaster, who'd obviously helped build the bridge. And then in his latter years, when he was 67, he unfortunately got diagnosed with lung cancer. But all he ever wanted to do was to go across the bridge. And even though he was quite ill, my uncle managed to take him across, and he just made the one crossing. And with a few weeks later, sadly, he did die. But it was lovely to think that he got across the bridge, because he felt such a part of the building of it, and it's the one thing that he wanted to do, and we managed to fulfill. And I think he was just so thankful that he'd got across there before, you know, it was too late for him to get across there. So it was one of his last memories, and one of the last memories that I have of him was him telling me the story, oh, quite excited, or, you know, Uncle Larry got me to cross the bridge, he managed to drive us over there. Was amazed at it, obviously amazed at what it was like just travelling over, because we didn't have roads or bridges like that, did we, very often, to cross over? None at the time. It was the only one. So yeah, it was just nice to think that his last wishes was fulfilled.